Very happy to inform you that today I am going to talk about fishermen responses. Very good afternoon, one and all. Most respected Vice Chancellor of our university, respected Registrar of Annamalai University, and Dean Director of CS Marine Biology, Annamalai University, Parangipeti. Today I am going to talk about fish human response. My dear friends, last webinar class, so I already explained what is the fish human system and T cell B cell classification and the organization of the human system. And last class, what are the active nutrition immunity in COVID-19? So that way, so I hope you are enjoyed a lot for this lockdown period. Once again, I would like to thank to our authorities of Annamalai University for this opportunity. My dear friends, fish immune response. Immune response means what? So when you the immune response will occur in our systems, whether it is involved in or the activation in when you occurs, maybe they entering the foreign particle in our system, or it will be happen automatically in our system. So already I told him last online classes, the immune responses is important role for antibody development. So that the antibody development is very important for that your organ growth and development. So that way the fish immune response, it is similar in higher organism also. That means higher animals also. So that way the immune response means what? Do you fish have immune response? All fish have an immune system. You know very well about that. To fight diseases, although the system is by no means as advanced as the ones found in mammals. So that way, do you fish have the immune system? You have the big question mark in compared to higher animals. So that way you have definitely, you can see this, the immune system occurs in fish, whether it is cartilaginous fishes or in bony fishes. So that way the immune system is an important role for the pathogens can still enter the body either through the physical injury or the digestive tract. So the immediately that pathogens, it is eliminated it, or it is involved in some metabolic activities or not. So that way you can see one by one, the fish immune system is an important role for all metabolic activities, for especially immune defense mechanism. So that way the immune responses is very much needed for the all the organism, not only for the fish. So that way another questions automatically come to our mind. What is that? Do you fish have lymph node? The lymph node is one of the immune organs in higher animal, for especially the mammals. The spleen, as in other vertebrate, is the major filter of blood-borne antigens. But it also perform immunopoietic functions. What is the meaning of immunopoietic? So the immunopoietic means it is the origin of the blood cells. So the origin of the blood cells, when you have the functions when you entering the foreign particle in our systems. So that way the fish don't have lymph nodes. In teleost fish, it is involved in hematophysis and may have immune functions that are comparable to lymph nodes in mammals. So you can understand this. So lymph node is absent in fish. So some of them, last online classes, they have raised the question, sir, lymph node is present in fish or not? That's why I am answering for that questions. Fish do not have lymph nodes. This is a basic questions. So next, the immune responses means the specific reactivity induced in a host by an antigenic stimulus is called immune responses. In scientific manner, immune response means what? The immune response means the specific reactivity induced. Maybe whenever in the foreign substances enter in the host, by and the antigen stimulus occurs. Immediately the antigens going to stimulus, having the stimulus induced. So that inducing of the antigen substances is called the immune response. It may lead to important, which may be either beneficial or injurious or indifferent. It is protection against invading microorganism. That is very important. The immune responses is very, very important for it is protection of our bodies. So that way the immune response is very needed for the systems. You know very well about that there are two types of immune responses there. Namely, you know pretty well about that, humoral mediated immunity and cell mediated immunities. That means HMI and CMI generally developed together, but either may be predominant, exclusively, or sometime act together, or sometime in opposites. My dear friends, the two type of immune response is very, very important. This two response is developed, occurs in same manner. It's developed in together, but the functional wise it will be differ. Maybe the two response combine to form develop antigen antibody interactions. Sometime they are not together going to activate the system. Sometime it will be oppositing in functions. So that way in fish immune responses, it is having two categories, namely that HMI, HMI and CMI. That means cell mediated immunity and humoral mediated immunities. So that way you know that HMI means it is a antibody mediated. In case of CMI, it is not a antibody mediated. So the HMI means it is a antibody mediated immune response. This antibody is produced from plasma cells. You know very well about that. The plasma cell is a key role for it is producing the number of antibodies in the system. For especially in fishes, the kidney is an important role for develop or produce the antibody. In this antibodies, this plasma cells present in blood and other body fluids. What is the meaning of the other body fluids? That is for lymph fluid, body fluid. It's provide defense against most bacterial pathogens and virus. It also participates in the pathogenesis of types hypersensitivity reactions and autoimmune disorders. My dear friends, you know the HMI is an important role for it is providing defense against the most vulnerable bacteria and virus. Not only for that, it is also involved in autoimmune disorders. So that way, the HME is an important role for its providing defense against virus and bacteria. And CMI, the cell-mediated immunity, means it is a specific immune responses that does not involve antibodies. Already I told him, the protect against fungi, virus, and intracellular bacterial pathogens. It's provide immunological surveillance and immunity against the cancer. So the CMI, its important role for what is that? Immunological surveillance and immunity against the cancer cells. In case of fishes, the CMI is produced in the thymus region. Thymus is responsible for cell-mediated immunity response activities. It is mediates the pathogenesis of delayed type 4 hypersensitivity reactions and certain autoimmune disorders. So these are the very, very important type 1, type 2, and type 3. In case of in fishes, the type 4 hypersensitivity reactions will occur. It is totally involved in defense mechanisms and certain autoimmune disorders. I think the MHI, its productions of antibodies. It is involved in four steps. You know very well about that. Log phase, and plateau phase, and decline phase. What will happen? First, you give the responses. When you enter the pathogens, it is called a primary response will occur. That primary response, how they are calculated, how their response will occur, means the four type of response will occur. The first phase, the entering the pathogens, that means is called a log phase, LAG log phase. Its distributions and the fat in tissues, contact with the immunocompetent cells. My dear friends, the primary immune response means whenever entering the pathogens, that stage is a log phase stage. On log phase, next stage, it is still rise in the titer of antibodies. It is still rise the and next level, entering the pathogens, response will occur, and after that response will rise conditions. That means increasing in the titer of the antibody. That type of phase is called log phase. And plateau phase means it's equilibrium between the antibody synthesis and the catabolism. You know very well about that. So that way the four phases is there. The third phase is plateau phase, means that antibody going to rise, and certain stage this antibody going to in between the equilibrium conditions. That equilibrium between the antibody synthesis and the catabolism, that phase is called a plateau phase. And next last phase, decline phase. The decline phase means the immune response going to decline condition. There is no any response. There is no any antibody rising conditions. So that type of space is called a decline phase. The catabolism exceeds production and thus titer falls. So the titrations, when you are going in the experimental studies, when you inject the antigens or we inject the any kind of substances in the system, immediately your system having the response. So that response is called the primary response. And next response is called the secondary response. Once again, the same antigen you are going to inject, that means its booster dose is called secondary responses. So that response, they have the same functions, will the same steps will occur, but comparatively the secondary response will more titer value, more rising at the antibodies. So you can understand that this primary and secondary responses is to initiate the antigenic stimulus. You can inject the antigens, what will happen? The stimulus will occur in different aspect, primarily and secondarily. the primary response, what is that? Differ both quantitative and qualitatives. It is slow and sluggish and start lived. It is a very, very important. The primary response will, it is a quantitative and qualitative wise, it will be differs. It will be very slow and sluggish and start lived responses. And long log phase and low titer of the antibodies. The antibodies is a number is, it's not for very good level of titer value. It is very low titer of the antibodies. And predominantly, IgM is an important role. My dear friends, you should remember this. The two type of antibodies, the two type of the immunoglobulin is very, very important. When you the primary response will occurs, so that time the predominantly IgM antibodies will be formed, will be occurs. Following to the primary response, that is called a secondary responses. That secondary response is prompt, powerful, and prolonged. It is short or negligible log phase. You see the previous slides. The log phase is very, very important. That log phase means what is that is? Initials. You are going to stimulate the responses. That log phase, in case of the secondary response, it is very short period and much higher level of antibodies for longer period. So this is another important for in secondary responses. The antibody level is going to higher, much higher to compare to primary responses. And predominantly the IgG antibody will occur. And second, you are going to raise the antibodies. You can inject the antigens in once again, the same antigen, what will happen? So that time the IgG, it's a stimulated and formed to involved in the antibody productions. So this secondary antibodies is a longer period, antibodies much more is higher conditions. So these are the very, very important for when you go into experimental studies, these two responses will occur in the system. In case of the fishes, maybe you are going to inject any kind of antigens, maybe the killed bacteria or the live bacteria, whatever it may be. So immediately you can going to have the titer value. So this titer value, how much you are going to raise the antibody in primary responses and as well as secondary responses. These are the basic principles of what will happen. Response will occur in primary and secondary. So that way, this cell-mediated immune response means this production of antibodies. This antigens enter the antigen presenting cell, that means APC, activated, what is that? Macrophage and dendritic cells. My dear friends, whenever the antibody antigens enter the system, immediately the antigen presenting cells, that means APC cells, activated. So that cell activated, immediately the macrophage and dendritic cells going to activate. Next, the APC cells bind with a major histocomplementary complex, that means MHCs. So that MHC2 complex is important role for binding to APC. And next, the immature T lymphocyte, T cells, binds with the earlier formed complex with the help of T cell receptor. So this cell mediated immune responses, the production of the antibody, what will happen? It is the only that APC cells is activated once the antigen is entering, but the same time the dendritic cell and the macrophage cells are going to activate. With the APC bind to the MH2 molecules. That molecules, the immature T cells bind with the either formed complex with the help of the T cell receptor. The whole complex production, the signal for activation of CD4 cells. My dear friends, you know very well about that CD4 and CD8. The CD4, it's activated for this production of the antibodies. And CD8, it is only cytotoxic lighting cells. So this CD4 is important role for production of the antibodies. This activation of CD4 cells for the maturation of T helper cells, that means TH cells. the forms the interleukin 2, 4, and 5, and 6. The B cell maturations and subsequently release of plasma cells. So these are the production of the antibody. This is called a cell mediated immune responses. The plasma cells forms the antibodies, and some of the plasma cells develop to memory cells. You know pretty well about that. Already I told in the last online classes, the two type of the cells is important role, T cell and B cells. The T cell and B cells are very important for antibody productions. For especially the T cells. The T cells is an important role for, what is that? Antibody productions with the help of the T cells. So that way, the cell mediated immune responses is important role for production of antibodies. These are the steps. This production of the antibodies, you can see the diagram. So antigen is entering. Immediately the antigen presenting cells are going to process the antigen process there. In the, it is creating, activating the macrophage cells and binding the MHC class 2 molecules and processing of the antigens with the help of the T cell receptors. That receptors will the help of T cells also is going to activate to help to produce the antibodies. How they are going to involved in the production of the antibody with the help of the interleukin 1, that means CD4 and CD8, also interleukin 1 receptor and interleukin 2 helper T cells and interleukin 2 receptors also give rise to form daughter T cells, and the helper T cells can stimulate B cells, effector T cells, and helper can be stimulate the divide against the antibodies. So these are the flow chart how their antibody going to produce in the cell mediated immune responses. My dear friends, so this is a short time I'm going to give some idea about the what is the meaning of the immune response. The immune response means production of the antibody, how their antibody produced with the help of the T cell and B cell. You're going to see the another diagram how the plasma cells going to secrete the antibodies with the help of the T cells and the B cells. So my dear friends, I hope within the short duration, what is the fish immune responses? You can see the all the, our online classes one by one. So if you have any doubt, please you refer that previous online classes. If you have any doubt and queries, please call me. Definitely I will rectify your queries. So this is the flow chart of whenever first you can antigen exposure in blood level, antibodies level going to increase in primary and secondary. How they are formed, the immunoglobulin IgM and IgG. And IgG, it is having immunological memory cells. That means the cell mediated immune response give rise to form antibody producing cells. That means plasma going to produce the antibodies, and the plasma cells are finally going to release the memory cells. Okay, my dear friends, these are the flow chart. I conclude this. The immune responses is a mechanism in higher animals and fishes. It is here. There is no any differences. It is in similar mechanism. Whenever the entering the antigens or pathogen in the system, immediately the two type of response will occur. One is humoral response, another one is cell mediated response. The primary response and the secondary response. The primary response, the four steps involved, what is the four steps means? Log phase, and plateau phase, and decline phase. So these are the antibody rising and declining level. Next, you against the same antigen you are going to inject, the what will happen? Immediately your antibody going to rise. So that way antibody rise and certain it will going to decline. So this is the conditions of whenever antigens entering or the pathogen entering system, your system going to activate, give rise to form the antibodies. My dear friend, thank you very much for one and all for this opportunity. If you have any doubt, you refer this book. I am very thankful to every one and all, and especially for the Ilaiya Perumal, I mean for wonderful support for this online programs. So that way I am very thankful to for the funding agency DST SAR project and the Government of India, New Delhi, for the financial support. So once again, and thank you one and all for your patience. Thank you very much. See you next class.